Chapter 5. The servants within the castle noticed the rapid growth in the Baroness's waistline. They muttered to each other, but said nothing to the Baron.
"My husband," said the Baroness at supper one evening, "I have some news."
"News?"
Sir Longsword sat at one side of the table.
"Good news, I trust, my lady," he said.
"Oh, very."
"Good. Well, we could all do with some good news. What is it?"
asked the Baron.
"I'm with child."
The Baron's mouth dropped.
"But when?"
"Well, it seems I've been expecting for some months."
Her eyes dropped.
"But didn't even know it. About a month left to go."
She stuttered, looking up at the Baron and seeing his beaming face.
"That's marvelous. We'll celebrate. We'll dance till our shoes are worn out. An heir. I'm to be blessed with an heir."
"Oh, I'm not sure about the dancing,"
she said as she looked to one side and caught Longsword's eye. He had been examining the Baroness's face very carefully, and watching as her expression changed from nervousness to relief with the Baron's reaction. He maintained his steady stare, but her eyes quickly fluttered down and away. Later that night, Longsword couldn't sleep. He paced around the wall walk of the castle, talking to himself.
"It's just a silly thing to think. Nobody would do that. It's just too awful to even think that someone might do such a thing."
He stood still for a moment.
"What would your mother say, Longsword?"
"She'd say..."
He changed positions and faced where he had been standing.
"You're a wicked boy for thinking such a thing. No one would do something so nasty. Now get outside and do your homework. Remember, bow and arrow practice today, and no excuses."
He scratched his head.
"I can't figure this out. There's definitely something wrong."
He leaned against the wall and stared over. Below him, he heard the sounds of the main gate opening and then shutting. Some muffled voices floated up in the still night air.
"That's Wister's voice,"
he muttered. Running down the steps, he headed through the gate and followed Wister out of the castle and through the village to a little house outside. He watched through the window as the magician stood over a table in the center of the room, muttering strange strings of words. In the chill air and the dead of each subsequent night, Sir Longsword followed the magician, and each night he couldn't quite make out what was going on. Deep in his bones, he worried that there was something strange happening. Something was wrong. January passed slowly. To Longsword, the bare trees always seemed at their bleakest at the beginning of the year. Every day it seemed to rain or snow from endlessly rolling dark gray clouds. The mud underfoot seemed to be the only thing that contained life, and he longed for the spring.